Welcome to our last video on matter and measurement, the first chapter slash topic covered in Chem 110. In the last video, we introduced the concept of dimensional analysis. What I would like you to do at this time is I would like you to attempt example number 2. It is very similar to example number 1, which was reviewed last video. Please pause the video and try this practice problem. The answer to this problem should be 2.3 gallons. You should have set it up so that 8.7 liters was first. That's our given. It's over 1. Remember that 1 is just a placeholder. And then I need to get rid of the unit I don't want. So liters needs to disappear. Since it's already on top in the numerator, in my conversion factor, it needs to be moved to the denominator. So I can cancel out just the unit and be left with gallons. Since 8.7 is on top and the 3.785 is underneath, you need to divide 8.7 by 3.785. And then because our given number here is only 2 significant figures, our answer should only be 2 sig figs as well. Let's discuss example number 3. In this example problem, you'll notice that instead of 1 unit, you now have 2. So you'll notice that you're given 452 meters per second, and you're asked to calculate miles per hour. So we're going to convert meters to miles and seconds to hours. We're going to set the problem up in a very similar manner to before. So I'm looking for miles per hour. So question mark miles per hour equals. This time for our given, because we have 2 units, they're going to be separated. So I have 452 meters, and I'm going to put that over my seconds. Now I'm going to do the exact same thing that I did in the past. So meters is on top. I need for it to diagonally drop and go to the bottom. And I'm looking for miles. So miles will go on top. 1 mile equals 1609 meters. I always make sure to keep the number with its unit. This is 1 mile. And then the 1609 meters. But I'm not done. At this point, I've only converted meters to miles. I need another conversion factor, and I'm going to convert my seconds to hours. Seconds right now is on the bottom. I need to get rid of it. It needs to disappear and cross out. Therefore, seconds is going to go on top. And over here, I wrote down that I want hours on the bottom. Therefore, the hours will go on the bottom. Now I add in my numbers. There are 3,600 seconds in 1 hour. I can cross out meters because it's both top and bottom. And I can cross out seconds because it's both top and bottom. Mathematically, you can decide at this point how you'd like to solve it. I usually just go in order and ignore the ones. So I would take 452 divided by 1609 and then times 3,600. The other option you have is just multiplying straight across and then doing the division. Either should work and give you the correct answer. I would then look at my given, which is 3 significant figures, and round my final answer to 3 sig figs. Therefore, the final answer should be right around 1,010 miles per hour. Remember, this 0 here does not count. It is just a placeholder, since there's not a decimal. At this time, what I would like you to do is I would like you to pause the video and try the following practice problems. I will provide you with a few conversion factors, and then you should try the problems yourself. The cubed units have already taken into account that cubing in the number. So don't change them. Don't cube them. Just leave them as is. At this time, pause the video and attempt these practice problems. The answers to all three questions are shown here. In the first one, you were provided with the two conversion factors up here. It was very similar to the last example we did together. I put my grams over my cubic centimeters, and then I set everything up so that I was able to cross things out. Grams was on top, so I diagonally dropped it to the bottom so it would cancel. Centimeters cubed was on the bottom, so I put it up top so it would cancel. And you're left with pounds over cubic feet, which is what the question is asking for. In the second one, you'll notice I did not provide any conversion factors because these are things that you should know. You should know there are 60 minutes in an hour, 24 hours in a day, and that there are 365 days in 1 year. This problem was a little unique because the beats was already given, 72 beats per minute, and it was asking you how many times the heart beats a year. So the only thing you had to change was the time. Minutes was on the bottom, so it had to go on top. Then hours was on the bottom, so it had to go on top. And finally, days was on the bottom, therefore it had to go on top. And you multiply straight across. The actual answer should have been 3784320. I rounded and used scientific notation so that I didn't have to write out all those zeros. The third question here is a little bit unique as well. You really didn't need any specific conversion factors because they were all provided in the problem. The $7 worth of gas is what you want to start with primarily because that's what the question actually is. It's saying how far can you go on 7 gallons of gas. The other provided numbers are actually the conversion factors they'd like you to use. So I put my $7 over 1, and then because I need to get rid of money, that's my unit. It's 1 gallon over 2.15, and then I'm looking for distance, so now that gallons is on top, it has to go on the bottom. So this turned into a conversion factor, as well as your 32 miles per gallon turned into a conversion factor. And then once again, you just multiply and divide, and you solve. You always want to go, really for this one, I like to say that you go with whatever the given was for sig figs. So this would be the answer because the given is 3. But you do have multiple numbers, and the lowest number provided is the 32. So 2 would have been okay as well. Let's continue our study of this chapter. There's only a little bit left. Measuring temperature. So temperature is defined as the measure of the heat energy of a substance, and it's measured with a thermometer. Of course, we already knew that. These are your temperature equations. The only one you really have to worry about memorizing is this one because it plays a major role later on. All we're going to do really is plug and chug. So you pick the proper equation and you plug your numbers in and you solve. At this time, please pause the video and attempt the practice problems. Please review your answers to those practice problems. Every equation should have been used once, and you are just plugging in the provided number and solving for the missing piece. The last part of the chapter refers to density and something known as specific gravity. This, for the most part, is probably review because it's often covered in middle school classes as well as most integrated science classes. Density is defined as how heavy an object is compared to its size. It is independent of amount because it is a ratio. Anything that is independent of amount is an intensive property. It is a ratio of mass to volume. Its units are usually grams per milliliter or grams per cubic centimeter. The equation for density, again, is one that you should be well aware of. Density equals mass divided by volume. Okay. You can also instead use this density triangle over here because ideally you could be asked to solve for any of the three pieces. If you're asked to solve for density, you would cover up the D and you would do mass divided by volume, right? So if this is gone, it's M over V. Instead, if you were asked to solve for mass, you would cover up the M, and you see that it's D times V. And finally, if you were asked to solve for volume, you would cover up the V and do M divided by D. Sig fig rules still apply, and you would be expected to show your work. Let's do this sample problem. What is the density of an object that has a mass of 54.2 and a volume of 31.7? All you have to do here is take your 54.2 divided by your 31.7, and you should end up getting 1.71, and the units would be grams per milliliter. On the next slide, there are some additional practice problems. Let's kind of briefly review these before you try them. The first two should be no problem. The third one says, what is the density of a cube with a 6.2 centimeter side? You have to first find the volume, which is length times width times height, and then do the math. The final question is for an irregular object. We're going to use volume displacement for this. So to find the volume, you have to subtract both milliliter amounts and then plug into your equation. At this time, please pause this video and try these four practice problems. Please check your answers for these practice problems. Remember, you should round for proper sig figs as well. Okay, the first two, again, should not have been a problem. The last two, you had to first find your volumes as shown, and then solve according to the equation. The final slide in this PowerPoint describes density versus specific gravity. Specific gravity is the ratio of density of an object to the density of pure water. The density of pure water is often rounded or estimated to be 1 gram per milliliter. Therefore, if I'm taking a number divided by 1 with a unit, I'm basically getting the density without a unit. These problems can be solved the exact same way as density. So what is the mass of an object with a specific density of 4.78 and a volume of 60? So you're going to plug this number in as density, and of course this number in as volume. And to calculate mass, we multiply. So mass will equal 4.78 times 60, and that will give you 287 grams. This concludes our study of matter and measurement.